Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, we are going to demonstrate an experiment on the transistor audio amplifier trainer kit. Why with this kit, we can observe the input-output impedance of a common emitter configuration of a PNP transistor. Also, we can find the output current gain, input current gain, and the power gain of the common emitter configuration. So we will move on to the experiment. Before that, I will describe you the circuit description of the kit. So the common emitter configuration of a transistor is widely used application since its output is and the current gain is very high. So we will very used in electronics very widely is a common emitter configuration, the PNP transistor in very larger used. So this is our trainer kit of transistor audio amplifier. The in amplification as we using BC177 transistor here, and in the common emitter configuration here we have provide the 9 volt DC supply to this circuit, and different resistor and circuit configuration are provided. So order code for this trainer kit is 36121, and this is the power on off switch with the toggle light lamp here is also provided. So this is the basic circuit. We are also providing user manual for all the experiments that we have done with this kit, and you can all easily verify and find out all the characteristics and different values from this user manual by doing the experiments. In accessories, we are also providing some patch codes to do the experiment connections. So now we will do the first experiment, which is to study of common emitter transistor amplifier circuit and to measure its voltage gains AV. For this we will follow the procedure and make the circuit as given in the user manual, and we will first give the input from the from the function generator and get the output at the CRO. So we will start making connections. So we will connect A to B of this transistor, and the complete circuit has internally connected, so we do not have to connect any other sources. Now we have to provide the input from the function generator. For this we will connect the function generator's output to the input of this circuit. So we will give input at this terminal here as shown in the user manual. In our circuit there is no short circuit connection provided, so we will provide direct input at this point and at this point. So we will give input to this capacitor section and negative to the ground. For observing the output we will use the CRO or the DSO. Right now we are using, so the output will be taken from the output terminal as noted down on the circuit board. So it will be connected ground with ground, and positive test probe will be connected with positive. Now as the procedure says, we will give the frequency generator's output of frequency of 1 kilohertz, and then we in steps increase the value from 1 millivolts to 10 millivolts and get the output at the CRO. So now we will set the frequency of a sine wave which is around 1000 hertz or 1 kilohertz as is saying in the user manual, and amplitude is 1 VPP. Now we will increase the amplitude in steps, and now we will power on the circuit by powering on this on off switch. So as I power on the circuit you can see the output waveform at the DSO, and also you can measure the amplitude here. So this is the 8.4 volts, and now we do not change the any value of volt per division and any seconds and horizontal and vertical value. Now we will increase the value of input VPP, and also at every step we will measure the value. So as I increase this value to 2 VPP, you can observe the value at the amplitude of waveform, which is 8.56. Now again I increase the value 3, similarly 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can increase value till the output is not distorted. So I will auto configure this DSO and see the amplitude. So amplitude is constant. I will more increase the value here. So this is the maximum value. At all the input values, take the output value of amplitude and put the both values in the formula given at the 7th step of the user manual by V note, by you can find out the output gain or voltage gain by applying this formula, which is the V note by VI. V note is the output amplitude that we are getting and VI is the input amplitude that we are sending with this audio frequency generator. That's how you can find the voltage gain by calculating this value. So that's we perform the first experiment of this transistor audio amplifier. So now we will move on to the second experiment, which is to plot the frequency response characteristics of a common emitter amplifier. For this, for first four step of the last experiment should be repeated. Now we will set the audio frequency generator at any value such that the amplifier output remain undistorted. So we will set the frequency of the audio generator. Before that, we will connect the DSO at the output terminals, and now we will change the frequency of the audio signal generator. So this is the frequency here. Any of the frequency we can set till the output is not distorting. So we can start with 1 kilohertz. So this is the 1 kilohertz frequency. Now we will remove the CRO from here and we will connect the digital multimeter here at the output terminal for measurement of voltage. So you can see I have connected a digital multimeter. Set this multimeter to the DC millivolt range. So this is the 200 millivolts range here. Now as I increase the frequency of the frequency generator, at the corresponding frequency we will measure the voltage, output voltage of the audio amplifier. So I will change this frequency to 2 kilohertz. Similar output will be observed at the DMM. Now as I increase the frequency, the output also decreasing here, you can see. So I am increasing the frequency. Now frequency is about 30 kilohertz, output is decreasing until a frequency value, the output again start increasing. In the positive. So as I giving the frequency is higher, you can see the output is now again increasing the value. So that's the output is increasing. After taking the readings at different steps, you will find out the frequency response of this audio amplifier by plotting the graph between taking the frequency at x-axis and gain of the audio amplifier at y-axis. So after taking the voltage, you can find out the gain and then plot the graph. So the graph should be resemble this circuit or this figure given in the user manual. So in your graph, your gain will increase when frequency is increasing till a medium point, and after that the gain makes constant, and then this will be decreasing again from the increment of the frequency. So this is the frequency versus gain plot of the audio amplifier with the PNP transistor. Now we move on to the next experiment, which is to find out the input impedance of the common emitter amplifier. So this is the circuit which we have to make the circuit connection. For this we will connect A point with the B point, and we also introduce the decay resistance box at this point in the input terminal, and we will provide the input from the audio frequency generator. So we will follow as the procedure says in the user manual. So we will connect the A point here with the B point with the help of this patch code, and now we introduce the decay resistance box at the terminal which is given in the user manual. So this is the point at which we have to use the decay resistance box. Here you can see that we have introduced the decay resistance box. Now we will connect the function generator's output at this terminal. So this resembles the circuit as given in the user manual. Now we will follow the rest of the procedure for audio frequency generator. It says we will set the audio frequency generator's outputs to 1 kHz, and the level of this will be set at to 5 VPP. So you can see I have set the value to 5 VPP here. This is the amplitude and this is the 1 kHz frequency that I have set, and the output from this audio frequency generator is given to the input of this signal here at the input terminals. Now we will observe the output with an CRO or a calibrated multimeter. You can also use the AC millivolts meter to measure the proper output. Right now we are using the CRO here. You can see this is the output of this CRO. So the amplitude measured by this CRO is saying that 8.6 volts are the amplitude of the channel 1. Now we will adjust the value of this decay resistance box about S value, and that we can find the half value of this output. So we will change the value of decay resistance box one by one. So we will find the half value of this output level. At this we will find out the input impedance of this common emitter amplifier. So we will increasing the resistance here. As I increase the resistance, you can see the waveform and the value of the resistance output amplitude is changing. Here you can see the values going lower. So we will try to reach this value with 4 VPP. So here you can see this is about the 4 VPP. So our output was 8 volts. Now we have reached the value about 4 VPP. At this time, find out at which value, which resistance value this occurs. So this was our input impedance, which we can find out with the decay resistance box. So when we reach the value at half, you can easily say this is the input impedance of this common emitter configuration amplifier. Now we move on to the next experiment, in which we have to find the output impedance of the common emitter amplifier. So we will follow rest of the four steps of the last experiment that we have done. Now we will set the audio frequency generator 1 kHz and the output of 5 millivolt, and similar process will be follow. Right now in this circuit, in last circuit we have connected the resistance box at the input side. Now we will connect this resistance box at the output side. Now we make the connection as per the circuit diagram. For this we will connect A to B, and resistance decay box will be connected to the output side. So we will connect positive and negative at the output terminals, so that we have connected the resistance box. Now we will give input from the audio frequency generator. So input will be given to this and this point. These are the input points here. Now we will set the audio frequency generator output same as in the last experiment that we have said, frequency 1 kilohertz and output input amplitude should be 5 BPP. So we have given the input here. Now we will measure the output from the CRO. So we can connect the CRO positive and negative at this value and try to find out the output. So we will first measure the output of this circuit. So first we will connect the DSO at output terminal. Here you can see the output is 8.5 volt VPP here from the input side, and this is the output amplitude. Now we will introduce the decay resistance box at the zero value. So this will make the short circuit and waveforms goes zero. Now as I increase the value of resistance till the amplitude goes to half value of that we have measured in the output, that was 8.5. So we will try to reach about 4.25 or 4.5 amplitude. So the at which resistance position that value achieved, this will be our output impedance. So as I now will increase the resistance value, so as I increase value in 100 ohms, so you can see the value has been reached to 2.24 volts. Now again I increase this 100k potentiometer, so this value is now reaching 3.6 volts and again I will increase, so this is about 4.4 BPP. So that was the half of our output amplitude. So at this resistance point we can say this is the input resistance of the common emitter configuration or transistor audio amplifier circuit. You can also add some of the proper resistance to find out proper half value. So if I increase 1k resistance, the value goes very high, so we cannot use more than that. For this we can use the other resistance lower than the 100 ohms steps, so in which we can add some of the resistance more and adjust the value properly and get the accurate half value of the output impedance. You can see the output impedance of this circuit is about the 300 ohms from this decay resistance book that we have found. So this is the output, how we found the output impedance of this common emitter amplifier. Now we move on to next experiment, which is to find out the current gain of a common emitter amplifier. For this we will make this circuit. In this we have to connect the decay resistance box at A and B point, between A and B point, and this circuit will be given and the output can be taken from these points. So now we will follow the steps from 3 to 6 from experiment 1, and then we connect the AC voltmeter to find out the VO, and then connect the AC voltmeter to VI to find out the VI at the DRBC and the output as well, and then put the values of VI and VO in the formula given here. So we will follow the steps to make the circuit. For this we will connect this decay resistance box between A and B point. So this is the positive and the other end of this resistance box. So we will find out at this point at here. Now we will give the input from the frequency generator at the input side, and in the frequency generator we have set the value of 1 kHz and 1 VPP. In steps we will increase the value of VPP from 1 to 10 and we will measure the output by DSO. So we will connect the DSO at the output terminals. So we have get our output. Now we will increase the value from 1k resistance So this is the 1k resistance. We will find out the millivolts at 1k resistance and also at 9 volt. Now if we use AC voltmeter across the decade resistance box, and we can find the value at different values of resistance. So we will change this value to 1k ohm of around 5k. You can see waveform has been changed. We can measure the current at the terminals of A and B by AC voltmeter. So you can measure the current by A and B at the AC voltmeter connecting the. So we will use CRO for measurement of the decade millivolts of the VI, which is the input voltage. At we will connect the CRO for this to the A and B terminal as well. Here right now we will see the input amplitude is now 1.1 volts and the resistance value is 5k by the decade resistance box. So this is the RI and RO is 1k at our resistance. Here at the circuit this is the RO, which is the 1k value. Now the load resistance and 1k, both the value has been taken. So after taking the values, we can enter the values in the formula which is given. So we have taken from the output end. RI is the input impedance, which is the 5k resistance that we have provided from the decade resistance box. RL is the load resistance, which is the 1k resistor. This should be 1. And VI is the input amplitude that we have provided from the frequency generator. So VI is the 5 millivolt and output is the 1.1 millivolt. That's how we can find the, after putting all the values in this formula, we can find the current gain of this common emitter amplifier. So after putting all the values, you can easily find out the current gain of the common emitter amplifier. In continuation of the object 6 in the manual, to find out the power gain of common emitter amplifier, that the results that we have obtained from the previous experiments, that can be substitute the value in the formula given from the power gain formula, and you can find out the power gain as well. So that's how you see how we do the experiment from the common emitter configuration or the transistor audio amplifier, which is the widely used product in the electronics industries as well. And by this we have found out the current gain, output impedance, input impedance and voltage gain as well, and power gain and the other characteristics and other parameters can also be found out by using and referring the user manual. So while performing the experiment, if you find any difficulties with this, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.